I really feel like this energy, though, is passing because you do have a really beautiful month ahead. You have really light energies month ahead, this month ahead, rather. So you have a lot to be excited about. I'm getting that you're looking towards the past a bit right now. You're feeling a bit sad and somber of maybe a transition that you're going through right now. You feel like you are coming out of one period, going into the next, and just know that this is a good thing. Just know that what you're putting behind you right now needs to stay behind you, and that it's okay. You're moving on to greener pastures. You need to kind of remain flexible and resilient throughout all of it. And you're definitely you're ready for a change, but don't spend too much time looking in the past direction. Turn your head, look forward, look at what lies ahead of you. Don't spend too much time in that space. It's really important to learn from our past and learn from our past mistakes and things that have come about in recent months. But just take what you've learned and move forward with it. And just know that you have the tools now that you need to look ahead and to really just kind of navigate the road that lies before you. I really feel like a lot of the heaviness that you were feeling, or maybe some darkness, or maybe some health issues, or even some financial issues are behind you at this point. And at least for this month, for the month of November, you do have some really fiery energies, some transformative energies, and you are more able, I feel like, to accept those gifts into your life and to really appreciate them more. You're at a stance right now where you're stronger, you're more enthusiastic. You're still coming out of this sort of cusp of not almost not believing it, or not feeling, feeling like, it's almost too good to be true that some of this is behind you. But just know that it is, and know that the your oracle message from the Mary Queen of Angels deck literally leaped out of the deck. Enthusiasm is the name of the card. So it's really quite fitting that this is the card that chose to jump out of the deck, the card literally of enthusiasm. And note the message here says, whatever I am most passionate about is the direction I follow. So really just remember your passions and just really focus on the things that you're most enthusiastic about, and really kind of let that be your driving force. Let that be what takes you from that old pattern of thinking, or maybe what was kind of bothering you or weighing you down these last few months. Let that be the driving force to bring you into this new period of just good fortune. And it's just a time, I feel, of positive change, and it's just really important to kind of set out on the right foot and do it in a passion of gratitude and really just getting back to this enthusiastic, energetic self that Gemini is. And again, a really wonderful way to go about that is by pursuing your passions, by pursuing your creative, your imaginative side. It's already budding. It's already coming through. You are feeling this change of season, like I said, and just go with it. There's just a really very light, airy energy that's coming through, that you are that you're embodying, and that you just feel really good. You just feel like you're changing and you're adapting. And that's another message that was coming through in your oracle card, is flexibility. And the message here is, I am flexible and adaptable to change while I pursue my ambitions. And that really seems to be coming through really strongly, is that you are adapting to this change, you're ready for it, and you're remaining flexible throughout all of it. And it's still a process, though. There's still this process of building, of changing, of just kind of starting anew, maybe collaborating. I have the Three of Coins or Three of Pentacles for you as well. And I really feel like this could be a work-related project. I feel like this could also be sort of a labor of love that some of you are working on. Maybe a book that some of you are writing, or I'm getting for some of you, it's some sort of play you're writing, or musical masterpiece, or something of the creative nature. This could also be a building project you're working on. You're working on some home repairs, or some other type of building projects. Again, like some other sort of labor of love, if you will. And as the message that came through before in the enthusiasm card, this is a really strong energy that's coming through this month. It's just really pursue those passions and let that be a really strong driving force for you. I'm getting that you're going to make some major headway with it this month. And if for some of you, if it is a writing project, I'm getting that some of you may even be able to get an appointment, maybe with a big publishing company, or landing in a certain editor that you've been seeking after. There's a major headway that's going to be coming this month with these sorts of creative projects. So keep chipping away at it, even if it is something that you did just start, you know, and you're not going to be completing this month. You're gonna put only so many hours into this project, but you're gonna see that it's really going to sort of take off. I'm getting that this is a big focus for you right now. So even though it may be just a labor of love, maybe it's not, you know, maybe you won't be making any money off of it, or maybe it won't even be seen by anybody else. I'm getting that it's something that's important to you. So if it's important to you, then that's really all that matters. And it could also be a collaboration at work, a collaborative project. Whatever it is, it's going to be taking off, and it's part of this new transition that you're in right now. And it's again going to be this strong driving force that's going to kind of bring you good luck and good fortune going into the new year. And it's going to kind of, I feel like whatever this is, it's going to set off some other sort of creative spark that's going to maybe lead you to other projects, or just kind of get the sort of creative juices going, if you will, that will bring you new ideas, fresh ideas. I also have the King of Swords for you. So this is definitely it could be some sort of intellectual project you're going on, working on, like I said, some sort of, you know, book or novel. But there's definitely fresh ideas that are coming through this month, fresh passionate ideas, intellectual ideas. This king, however, I'm also sensing that for some of you, this is also representing an actual person, a new love interest in your life, a new passionate, fiery individual for some of you. It could be an igniting of somebody, an old flame, somebody from your past. I have the Knight of Wands as well here for you. Whoever this person is, it's definitely a very it's somebody that excites you. It's somebody that's really very someone that you were very passionate about, that may be it coming in again. I'm sensing either by mid-month or by the end of the month. It almost feels like to me, this is what it feels like, that the energy that you are, that you're kind of exuding because of this kind of new mojo that you're experiencing with this this creative project that you're working on. You're kind of breaking ground with it. You're sort of exuding that kind of energy. You're just sort of like on fire, if you will, and you're attracting like-minded individuals. You're attracting intellectual individuals, creative individuals, and it's kind of what's bringing back this spark in this either this old relationship or in this new person that you're going to meet. You're really just exuding this this like charm, I want to say, and it's attracting new people into your life, whether or not it is a romantic partner or not. It could be somebody that you meet. I'm getting almost either in the workplace or something that's related to the creative project that you're working on. It's going to only enhance these creative gifts that you have and this new spark that you have, like I said, that's going into the new year. This person is going to be kind of bringing new life to that, and vice versa. You're going to be doing the same for them as well, helping them kind of reignite the spark in their life creatively. But yeah, but I'm getting for a lot of you, this is a new love interest, a really exciting love interest, somebody who just there's a lot of passion, there's a lot of there's a lot of steamy romance there, and it's exciting, and it's and like I said, it's going to be coming your way either mid-month or the end of the month, so look for that, and so welcome that, and just be adaptable to it. I have the Temperance card for you as well. So, really the energies that are coming in, this just really follows the message that was coming in the Oracle card is to just be extra flexible this month, which you tend to be. You are an adaptable sign. But I'm sensing that because you're in this time of change and you are going about it enthusiastically, you are welcoming it, you are welcome to change, but just be extra flexible to it. Just try and have this, an attitude of gratitude and just be balanced with it, because some of the changes might be changes that you're not you don't you you know you almost don't see coming, or maybe you don't think they're good changes at first, but trust me, they are. You're going to realize that maybe at a later point, but just know that it's all good. Everything that's coming your way is all good. I'm getting for some of you're going to have increased intuition this month as well, increased communication with angelic guidance, with your spirit guides. For some of you're going to be getting guidance from your ancestors coming through. You're going to be getting messages from, I'm getting some, for some of you, this is a grandmother that's coming through, a recently, passed grandmother, someone that you were very, very close to, yes, I'm getting a paternal grandmother for some of you. This message obviously only applies to some of you, but a paternal grandmother is coming through, someone who may have recently lost someone on their paternal side. She's going to be giving you some messages this month, so look out for those. Those are going to be extra impactful and resourceful. And obviously welcomed, you know, if this is someone that you really cared about. But for the rest of you, there's going to be increased angelic guidance, increased intuition. The intuition is, I feel like a lot of it is centered around this creative spark that you are experiencing this month. So, you know, anytime we're in this space where we're feeling good creatively, or, you know, our energetic and imaginative juices are kind of are flowing, we open up that portal for that for that angelic guidance to kind of flow and to come in, and that's really good. I mean, anytime we're in a space where we're able to receive those messages and our vibration is high enough where we're able to receive those messages, you know that you're on the right track, you know? So like I said before, that really awesome creative energy field that you're entering is attracting, you know, not only, you know, maybe new love into your life, but it's that same energy that's attracting this angelic guidance, increased guidance perhaps from your spirit guides as well, like I said. So really just look for that and just be excited about it, be centered for it, be ready for it, be flexible for the messages that are coming in and the changes that are coming. Like I said, some of them may seem a little bit, you know, strange at first, or maybe you don't understand, or maybe you don't understand some of the messages that are coming at first, but you're going to, it's going to make sense later on.